Just waking up in the morning, gotta thank God. I don't know, but today seems kind of odd.
And today, we are finally back and doing another video. It has been a long time coming, and we, as I put in emphasis, are finally doing more videos on games and different things like that. Today, we're going to be starting with games that are being turned into movies, like the new Five Nights at Freddy's official teaser. It came out a couple days ago, but we decided that we wanted to kind of get school out of the way and be able to do these videos freely and give you the best content ever. Now, I of course put emphasis on we because finally my friend Jaleel's back.
Hello, my fellow YouTube peeps. I hope you enjoy the video.
And we are finally back, and of course there is a lot more people than there was before. Before we had maybe 100 subscribers, now we are here with 655 of you, and I am so happy that we were able to share this journey, and let's get into the video. Are you ready, Jaleel?
Yep, and thank you guys for the support. We hope you like the video.
All right, let's go.
Welcome to Freddy Fazbear's Pizzeria, where fantasy and fun come to life. Hit it, guys. If you're watching this video, it means you've been selected as Freddy's newest security guard.
Hello?
We're going to have so much fun.
Okay. I hate to pause the video, but did you just see that, Julio?
Yes, I saw that. Freddy was right behind Mike.
Yes, I didn't even... Okay. So, yeah, he's right there. Honestly, I'm just trying to really digest the trailer. So, I'm not going to pause after this, but I was just kind of surprised right there. So, I'm not going to pause it, and then after this... Then we're going to kind of go back and go through the highlight moments.
All right.
We're going to have so much fun together.
Okay, the teaser is officially over, and I want to go over some highlight moments in the teaser. So, what I liked when they first kind of introduced, they kind of introduced with the girl, I don't know exactly who that is, but they kind of introduced, and they kind of brought in the feel of the movie. And I'm glad that we're going to be seeing more things happening on the outside of the actual, of course, of the arcade, but the outside and the inside. Because I see, like, we're kind of outside, it looks like, in the scene. So I like that we're going to be going, we're not just focusing on the arcade, but the actual outside of it as well. How do you feel about that?
I feel very intrigued and interesting, Kendrick. Despite that, this game will follow through FNAF 1, 2, and 3. The story looks pretty good, to be honest.
Yeah, I'm actually really interested to see how they're going to incorporate all three. Or maybe this... So, do you say it's the first, second, and third? Or is it going to just be following the FNAF 1 storyline?
Well, possibly all three. Since we got that from the synopsis, and Matthew Lillard confirmed that.
All three. It's going to be interesting to see how they incorporate all three games into one movie, because just incorporating one takes a lot of time and just takes a lot of money in general. So I'm interested to see how they're going to incorporate three. But I think I could see them incorporating three by... not just like putting them in like the areas, because in each FNAF game, of course, they were in different kind of landscapes. Like in FNAF 1, of course, you know, Mike, of course, he was in the security room. And then in, I believe, and just in different, in the games, there's just been different landscapes. So I'm interested to see if they're going to do, like, flashbacks. And they do flashbacks into, like, the different stories. And then we go into, like, this main story. But how do you think they're going to do it, Jaleel?
I think they're going to incorporate it because now I think it's taking place in the 80s. And then when possibly William Afton will create FNAF 2, he will probably create it in the 90s. Or probably he'll turn into Springtrap and then FNAF 3 starts. But who knows?
True. This trailer is just really interesting. And I see that they incorporated the ball pit, which is really, really iconic. And I'm glad that they did that. Now, one thing that I have been hearing a lot about is how they chose to do the red eyes instead of doing the, like, of course, the iconic black eyes. But I, honestly, it's a choice. But I feel as if they wanted to change it, that they maybe could, possibly. But I just feel like it's kind of what we're getting. I just hope it has a good storyline and it just makes sense. Because I hope it's not just one of those things where they kind of just plop us there. Or it's not like one of those game-to-movies adaptations like Tomb Raider or anything like that. So, I'm just really, I really hope this movie is good. It's looking pretty good from the teaser. So, how do you think this movie is going to be?
Well, in my opinion, I feel like it's going to be a masterpiece. Since me and a whole other FNAF fans have been waiting for this for 8 years now, and complaining about the red eyes is kind of stupid. It's just these new FNAF fans, but we OG FNAF fans, we respect it. I mean, it's not the best type of eyes, but we accept it. We don't want this movie to get delayed again.
True, and that is fair, because I already know that if it becomes too much of an uproar, that of course they're going to do kind of like how they did with Sonic when they have to do the redesign. They kind of just push back the movie a little bit just to do that. And honestly, I'm ready for this movie. So honestly, the red eyes doesn't really bother me as much. So it's kind of just like, okay, red eyes, it's a choice, whatever. As long as it's a good movie and it's solid and hopefully it makes enough box office so that we can get more of these, then I'm fine with it, honestly.
I mean, yeah, I mean, the eyes are not the best choice, but, you know, it's a good choice. But just accept that you're actually getting the movie after 8 years.
True. And I'm just so glad we were able to do this. Also, I want to give a shout out to Jaleel, because once we did part ways, we both kind of focused on our own side of the channels. So now I have a channel and he has a channel. What is your channel, Jaleel?
Well, it's mostly about video games, comic book movies, video game movies, all that kind of stuff, you know. You know, I just want to get enough views. I already have 123 views, and you know, and you already have 600 subscribers, so I'm kind of jealous, but I'm happy for you, man.
Thank you. And what's the title, the name of your channel?
It's Jaiku2099.
Okay, so I want you guys to go ahead and subscribe to that channel. And I hope you guys had an amazing time here. We hope to see you guys in the next video. See ya.
All right, see you guys. Hope you liked the video.